ancient agricultural mysteries. Plants are an integral key to understanding the old ways. Our ancestors attached symbolism to different plant parts such as flowers or leaves because of what their shape resembled, or even what the nature of the environment in which they grew suggested. Often something of their physical nature indicated magical power, such as the sunflower always turning to face the sun, or the moonflower only opening its petals at night. Here they symbolize many abstract principles, and therefore we find them included in the mythology of ancient gods and goddesses. Other reasons for including plants as occult symbols are related to what we now term their pharmaceutical or chemical natures. Occult symbolism appears in the act of the seed pushing its way up through the soil. The plant grows from a seed, flowers produce seed, and dies, so too is the life of a man or woman. The beauty of the flower is fleeting in its time. A tree was rooted in the earth and stretched upward, extending its branches into the sky. Trees provided shelter and food for living things, and our ancestors highly revered them as spiritual beings. The oak tree was sacred to many cultures, particularly to the Druids and Celts. In southern Europe, the walnut tree was worshipped as sacred to Diana, Hecate, and Persephone. The Scandinavian world tree known as Yggdrasil symbolized the supporting structure of the nine spheres of Teutonic cosmology. In Hebrew mysticism, the magical and philosophical system known as the Kabbalah is based upon a tree design. Ancient sorcerers, magicians, and prophets carried staffs or wands made from sacred trees as a sign they were emissaries of the gods. Later, such sacred objects came to be viewed as vessels of magical power wielded by the magician. From the view that plants were magical arose the tradition of carrying roots such as the mandrake or pouches filled with special herbs as a means of transporting the power of various plants. Making wreaths with sacred plants was an attempt to draw the power of the associated deity, enclosed in a ring which symbolized its cycle in the wheel of the year. To wear such a wreath denoted that person as a divine king, one who represented the deity here on the earth. The magical staff of Dionysus was a giant fennel stalk capped with a pine cone. He typified the divine kings who became the slain gods of European paganism so common throughout all of Europe. Essentially, the concept of the slain god is that the vital essence of the deity dwelling within the human vessel is buried in the earth to renew the fertility of the land. The ancients understood that life sprang forth from the seed, and that seed came forth from the plant at the height of its vitality. To control that vitality, one had to harvest the plant. From this basic pagan concept arose the custom of slaying the divine king. Over time, the slaying of human beings evolved into the killing of animals associated with the cult of a particular god or goddess. The discovery of thousands of Paleolithic and Neolithic icons is clear evidence that the earliest forms of worship focused on animals.
Thank you for watching. I hope to see you again soon. Till the next time, much love.